We want to solve the given log equations. To solve a log equation, if we have more than one log, we want to combine the logs using the properties of logarithms, then isolate the log, write the equation as an exponential equation, and then solve for x. So looking at our first example, our first step here is going to be to combine these two logarithms. Notice how they're both common log, and they're being added together, which means we can combine these into a single log by multiplying the number of parts of the logs, or multiplying x and the quantity x plus 3. So log x plus log of the quantity x plus 3 is equal to log of x times x plus 3, and this still equals 1. Again, we're multiplying the number of parts of the logarithms because we have a sum. And this is common log, and therefore the base is 10. So now we're going to write this in exponential form, where the base is 10, the exponent is 1, and the number would be x times the quantity x plus 3. So we'd have 10 to the first equals x times the quantity x plus 3. And now we need to solve this equation for x. 10 to the first would be 10. We'll distribute here, so we have x squared plus 3x. And since we have a quadratic, we're going to set this equal to 0 and see if we can factor it. So we'll subtract 10 on both sides. This would be 0 equals x squared plus 3x minus 10. Looks like this will factor. The factors of x squared are x and x. We want the factors of negative 10 that add to positive 3. That would be a positive 5 and a negative 2. And now this product will equal 0 when x plus 5 is equal to 0 or x minus 2 is equal to 0. So x equals negative 5 would make this factor equal to 0, or x equals positive 2 would make this factor equal to 0. But now in solving a log equation, it's important that we always check our solutions. If we go back to the original equation and try to substitute x equals negative 5, remember the number part of a logarithm is always going to be greater than 0, so x can't equal negative 5 because it's not in the domain of log x. Therefore, we must exclude x equals negative 5. Let's go and check x equals 2. If x is 2, we'd have common log of 2 plus the common log of 5 equals 1, which is true, but let's go ahead and check it. Common log of 2 plus the common log of 5 does equal 1. Therefore, our solution is x equals 2. Let's take a look at our second example. Again, we have two logs with base 4 that are being subtracted. So our first step is to combine these two logarithms. And since we have a difference this time, we're going to divide the number of parts of the two logs. Log base 4 of the quantity x plus 2 minus log base 4 of the quantity x minus 4 is equal to log base 4 of the quantity x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 4. This is the quotient property of logarithms. This is still equal to 2. Now that we have a single logarithm on one side of the equation, we're going to write this as an exponential equation where the base is 4, the exponent is 2, and the number is this quotient. So 4 to the second must equal the quantity x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 4. Well, 4 squared is equal to 16. I'll write this as 16 over 1 equals the quantity x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 4. I wrote this as 16 over 1 because now we have a proportion. So now to clear the fractions, we can cross multiply. 16 times the quantity x minus 4 must equal 1 times the quantity x plus 2. Now we'll clear the parentheses and solve for x. So we'll have 16x minus 64 equals x plus 2. Now we need to solve for x. We need to get x on one side of the equation. Let's go ahead and subtract x on both sides. Notice how when we do this, this is 0, so the x terms are now on the left side. So let's also undo this minus 64 by adding 64 to both sides. So now we have 16x minus x, that's 15x, equals 2 plus 64 is 66. Divide both sides by 15. This simplifies to x equals 66 fifteenths, but these do share a common factor of 3. So x is equal to 22 fifths. Now this answer would be much more difficult to verify, but let's at least make sure that this does not produce a negative number in the logarithm. Notice if x is 22 fifths, 22 fifths plus 2 would be positive, so that's fine. In this log, we'd have 22 fifths minus 4, but 22 fifths minus 4 is the same as 22 fifths minus 20 fifths. So this would be equal to 2 fifths, which is still positive. Therefore, x equals 22 fifths would be our solution. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.